some of Roy's folks.
In downtown Madison.
Well, the building itself was built in 1908, but this is where
it's a relic of the city's past.
And so you can look in here. This is where the elevator is. There's only like three of them in town. And the first occupants, Mr. Knight and Mr. Sterling Webster, opened up a hotel and a hardware store here. Can you see the spot on the floor, Chad?
And Mr. Knight left quite an impression.
That's where Mr. Knight used to stand, and the crush on the end. And he would stand there for so many years, and I guess just kind of rock back and forth, so he's embedded history into the floor.
There's been a number of businesses in this building over the years, but since 1995, it's been known as Madison Dry Goods.
This is the original counter here. That's original.
There's no hardware for sale here now, but the shelves are filled with bits and pieces of the past, collected by store owners Richard and Kathy Miller.
Richard and I both like antiques.
And the antiques aren't for sale either. But half the store, they do sell things that represent.
This is our number one seller.
Richard's lifetime in the apparel business.
We carry unique items.
The other half is a recreation of an old-fashioned country store.
Well, the country store, it's kind of my wife's baby.
All the products that I buy, I test everything. If I don't like it, then I don't put it in the store.
A visit here,
the sound of success,
is like stepping back in time.
The upstairs is all intact.
Especially when you step upstairs.
So all the original rooms are upstairs of the hotel rooms.
What was once a hotel is now a museum.
Pretty typical of what you would see for a hotel room.
Everywhere you look, you'll find artifacts from Madison's history.
Okay, that room represents Penn Hardware, the hardware store that was here.
And the best part, there's no charge for the museum tour.
There's a lot of history and people enjoy seeing it.
We like to have a place that people walk in and it's kind of reminiscent. It gives you the warm fuzzies.
For the Millers, this is much more than a business.
This is a piece of history.
And they're doing their best to preserve it.